Hi, welcome back. In today's class, we are going to do transformation of sentences. What do you mean by transformation of sentences? Very simple. Transformation of sentences means changing the form of a sentence without altering the sense of the sentence. What? Changing the form of the sentence without altering the sense of the sentence. The meaning of the sentence remains unchanged. Only the form of the sentence undergoes change. Okay? Yes. I will tell an example. I wrote a letter. A letter was written by me. Basically, is there any difference in the meaning of the sentence between these two sentences? No. I wrote a letter. A letter was written by me. Meaning is same. There is no any basical difference in the meaning of the two sentences. One is in active form, another is in passive. That is all, isn't it? This is what is called transformation of sentence. Changing the form of the sentence without altering the meaning of the sentence. Okay? Yes. What a hot day. What a hot day means? The day is very hot. What a hot day is in? It is an exclamatory sentence. The day is very hot. It is an assertive sentence. Even though one is assertive and another is exclamatory, meaning is same. Isn't it? Yes. Another, for example, nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible means everything is possible. Isn't it? So, basically, is there a difference between these two sentences? No. Nothing is impossible means everything is possible. One is in a negative, another sentence is in affirmative. Isn't it? This is what is called the transformation of sentence. Transformation of sentence simply means changing the form of a sentence without altering the sense of the sentence. So, the meaning of the sentence remains the same. Only the form of the sentence undergoes the change. This is what is all about transformation of sentences. Okay, right. Then, there are mainly five kinds of transformation of sentences. How many? There are mainly five kinds of transformation of sentences. Let us see which are these five kinds of transformations. First one is, these are the five kinds of transformation that we are going to discuss. Transformation of assertive, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory sentences. Transformation of negative and affirmative sentences. Transformation of active and passive voice sentences. Transformation of positive, comparative and superlative degree sentences. And transformation of simple, compound and complex sentences. So, these are the five transformation that we are going to do. The first two ones are comparatively very easy. The third and the fourth is not that much easy. And the fifth one is a bit difficult, that is all, because it is a advanced level of grammar. It is a higher level of exercise. So, it is according to the difficulty level that I have arranged. So, let us go from the simple to the complex. We will be going for three sessions for the transformation of sentences. This will be our first session. Today, we will discuss only the first two transformations, that is transformation of assertive, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory sentence and the transformation of negative and affirmative sentence. Only these two we will do in our first session. Transformation of active and passive voice sentence, transformation of positive, comparative and superlative degree sentence we will do in our second session, and the last transformation of simple, compound and complex that we will do in our third session, because this is a higher order grammar. This is not so easy. This one is not so easy as the first four ones. So, a separate session is needed for this. Okay. In today's class, we are going to discuss the first two transformations. So, let us examine transformation of assertive, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory sentence. For doing the transformation of this assertive, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory sentence, first we must know what is this assertive, interrogative, imperative, exclamatory sentence and all, isn't it? I think you are already familiar with it. It is very simple. You might have already learned it. What is an assertive sentence? Very simple. Assertive sentence is a sentence which is in the form of a statement. What do you mean by statement? Making a statement, a declaration, isn't it? We are learning English grammar. We are learning English grammar. It is a statement. It is a declarative sentence. English language is a very simple language. It is a statement, isn't it? Such a sentence is called assertive sentence. What is an interrogative sentence? Interrogative sentence is a sentence which is in the form of a question. Whatever question it is. Question word question or yes or no question. All kinds of questions belong to interrogative type. What is your name? Where are you going? All this. How old are you? So, any kind of question belongs to interrogative sentence. Imperative sentence. What is an imperative sentence? Imperative sentence is a sentence which is in the form of command, request or wish. What? Command, request or wish. All these things we discussed when we were doing direct and indirect. Command, request or wish. Bring the criminal. It is a command, isn't it? March forward, isn't it? Command. Will you please show me the way to airport? It is a request, isn't it? Please give me a lift, isn't it? May God bless him, isn't it? Happy Diwali. All these are wish, command, request and all. So, it belongs to imperative type. And exclamatory sentence. What is an exclamatory sentence? Exclamatory sentence is a sentence that shows a sudden feel, isn't it? Horror, terror, excitement, enthusiasm, joy, isn't it? What a hot day this is, isn't it? How, what a sunny morning, how beautiful the bird is, isn't it? Usually, an exclamatory sentence started with how, what way. So, all these things you know. So, this is what we are going to do first, the transformation of assertive, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory sentence. First, let us do the conversion or the transformation of exclamatory sentence into assertive. Then we will go for interrogative sentence into assertive. Then we will go for imperative sentence into interrogative. Understood? Okay. So, first let us go for exclamatory into exclamatory sentence into assertive. So, first exclamatory sentence into assertive we are going to convert. I will give two examples. Exclamatory sentence into assertive and vice versa. And vice versa. So, we will do the other way around also. See this sentence. What a hot day. This sentence is an exclamatory sentence, isn't it? Yes. You can change it into a assertive sentence. Very simple. What a hot day means the day is very hot. The day is very hot, isn't it? What a hot day means the day is very hot, or it is a very hot day, isn't it? So, is there any difference meaning what a hot day and the day is very hot? No, even though one sentence is an exclamatory sentence and the other is an assertive sentence, basically there is no any difference in meaning. This is what is transformation of sentences all about, isn't it? Just to change the form of the sentence without altering the meaning of the sentence. What a hot day. The day is very hot. See another sentence. How horrible the sight is. How horrible the sight is. How horrible the sight is. Usually, an exclamatory sentence starts with what a or how. How horrible the sight is. How horrible the sight is means? The sight is very horrible. Isn't it? The sight is very horrible. The sight is very horrible. The sight is very horrible. Isn't it? Yes. So, even though this one sentence belongs to exclamatory and another belongs to assertive, meaning is same. If we can change an exclamatory sentence into assertive, we can do the other way around also, isn't it? If we can go through this way, through the same way, we can return also, isn't it? So, now let us do vice versa, means we will do an assertive sentence and we will convert it into an exclamatory sentence. Okay, see this sentence. See this sentence. The morning is very sunny. It is an assertive sentence, isn't it? How can we convert it into an exclamatory sentence? Very simple. The morning is very sunny. What a sunny morning, isn't it? What a sunny morning. Exclamation mark. Isn't it? Yes. So, this is assertive, this is exclamatory, meaning is same. See the sentence. He lives a miserable life. He lives a miserable life. Sentence is, of course, assertive. Can't you change it into an exclamatory sentence? Yes, of course. He lives a miserable life. What a miserable life he lives. What a miserable life he lives. What a miserable life he lives. Okay, so one is assertive, another is exclamatory. So this is how you can change exclamatory sentence into assertive and vice versa. Only the form of the sentence is getting changed, meaning remains the same. Okay, so now we have done the transformation of exclamatory into assertive and vice versa. Now let us do the transformation of interrogative sentences into assertive and vice versa. Interrogative into assertive. Interrogative. Interrogative sentence, you know, interrogative sentence is a sentence which is in the form of a question. But here, all kinds of questions cannot be changed into an assertive sentence. There are mainly four kinds of questions, isn't it? Question word question, yes or no question, alternative question, and one more question is a rhetorical question. Only this last type of question can be converted into assertive. That is rhetorical question. What is a question word question? You know, question word question is a question that starts with a question word. When, where, why, and all. Where are you going? What is your name and all. Yes or no question is a question that starts with an auxiliary verb. And the answer will always be either yes or no. Did you buy that yesterday? Will you come here tomorrow? These are yes or no questions. And the alternative question is a question for which the answer is neither yes nor no, isn't it? Should we go to a park or on the beach? So answer will be neither yes nor no. This alternative answer will be this alternative question. And what is this rhetorical question? We have to see what is a rhetorical question. Because only a rhetorical question can be, that kind of interrogative sentence can be changed into assertive. So, we are concerned with the rhetorical question. So, I will tell you what is a rhetorical question. Usually, why do we ask a question? We ask a question in order to collect some information from somebody, isn't it? It is in order to get an answer or information from someone, that we usually ask a question. Where are you going? What is your name? Will you come here tomorrow? Isn't it? So, we will get some information. But this rhetorical question is a question which is asked not to get any answer or information, but to say something emphatically. What is it? A rhetorical question is a question which is asked not to collect any information or to get a reply, but to say something emphatically. For example, see this. I helped someone whenever he was in difficulty. Always I helped him. But when I was in difficulty, he did not help me. Such people also are there. Then, what question I can ask him in such a situation? With moral indignation, I can ask him the question, is this your gratitude? So when I ask him, is this your gratitude, do I expect any answer from him? No. When I ask him, is this your gratitude, I simply mean to say that this should not be your gratitude. Isn't it? So, I am emphatically saying that fact, putting it in the form of a question. Isn't it? This kind of question is called rhetorical question. A question which is asked to say something emphatically. Who cares him? When we say who cares him, do we expect any answer? No. When we say who cares him, what do we mean? Nobody cares him. Isn't it? So, this kind of question is converted from interrogative into assertive. Only this kind of question can be transformed. So, let us see how we can transform some questions like this. I will write two examples and let us transform from one form to other. Okay, right. Okay, see these sentences. Now we are converting interrogative into assertive. Isn't it? Only rhetorical question can be transformed. See, why worry about what people say? Why worry about what people say? What will be the meaning of this sentence in assertive? You should not worry about what people say. You, assertive will be, you should not worry about what people say. Why worry about what people say? You should not worry about what people say. That will be the assertive. Is there any difference meaning? No, not at all. Who doesn't know about coronavirus today? These are the days of coronavirus. Who doesn't know about coronavirus today? What does it mean? Everyone knows about coronavirus today, isn't it? Okay. Everyone knows about coronavirus today. Who doesn't know about coronavirus today means everyone knows about coronavirus today, isn't it? Okay. I never asked you to do it. So, till now we converted interrogative into assertive. Now, vice versa. Assertive into interrogative. Okay. I never asked you to do it. I never asked you to do it. This is assertive. How can we convert it into an interrogative? Yes, very simple. I never asked you to do it. Did I ever ask you to do it? Did I ever ask you to do it? Did I ever ask you to do it? So, meaning is same, form is different. Then, we should not waste our time like this. We should not waste our time like this. Obviously, it is assertive. How can we convert it into
how can we convert into interrogative?
Yes.
We should not waste our time like this. Why should we waste our time like this? Why should we waste our time like this? Why should we waste our time like this? Why should we waste our time like this means we should not waste our time like this, isn't it? Even though the format of the sentence is different, the meaning is same. This is what is called transformation of sentence. What is transformation of sentence? Changing the form of a sentence without altering the sense of the sentence. Okay, right. Now, let us go for the next transformation. So, what is the next transformation? Transformation of imperative sentence into interrogative sentence. Imperative sentence is usually not converted into assertive. It is usually converted into interrogative. Imperative into interrogative. Okay. Imperative sentence into interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence. Imperative sentence, you know. Imperative sentence is a sentence which is in the form of a command, request or wish. That we already discussed. How we can convert this command, request, etc. into an interrogative sentence, into a question, without changing the meaning. Okay. Again, I am going to write two pairs. Okay. See these sentences. Please show me the way to airport. Please show me the way to airport. Obviously, it is an imperative sentence. It is a request. How can we convert it into interrogative? Very simple. Please show me the way to airport. Will you please show me the way to airport? Will you please show me the way to airport? This is a question. This is a request. Even though this is in the form of a request and this is in the form of a question, meaning is saying, please show me the way to airport. Will you please show me the way to airport? Is there any difference in meaning? Not at all, isn't it? Only form is different. Keep quiet. Of course, a command, isn't it? Imperative sentence. How can you convert into interrogative?
Yes.
Will you keep quiet? Keep quiet. Will you keep quiet? So, command is put in the frame of a question. Meaning is same. Keep quiet. Will you keep quiet? What are same in meaning? Then. Now let us go the other way around. Now interrogative into imperative. Here we were converting imperative into interrogative. Now we are converting interrogative into imperative. Okay. Will you please give me a lift? Will you please give me a lift? Interrogative. Even though the meaning is in meaning it is a request, in form it is interrogative, isn't it? Okay. Will you please give me a lift? What will be the imperative? Very simple. Please give me a lift. Please give me a lift. So it became imperative, a open request. Will you get out of here? Yes. Will you get out of here? Interrogative. What will be imperative? Get out of here. That is all. Get out of here. Get out of here. Isn't it? So, these are very simple things. Converting the sentence from one form to another. So, this is the first transformation. Transformation of assertive, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory sentences. Okay, now let us see the second transformation, that is transformation of negative and affirmative sentences. What is this negative and affirmative sentence? Very clear. A negative sentence is a sentence that contains a negative idea. And very often words showing negation like not, never, etc. will be there in a negative sentence. But an affirmative sentence means simply a positive sentence. There will be no words of negation in an affirmative sentence. An affirmative sentence openly expresses a positive idea. That is all. Now, let us transform some negative sentences into affirmative and vice versa. I will write some sentences and let us transform it one after the other. First, let us change negative sentences into affirmative. Okay. He is not illiterate. He is not illiterate. Of course, sentence is negative. Not is the. What will be the affirmative? Very simple. He is not illiterate means he is literate. That is all. Okay. So, affirmative will be he is literate. So, he is not illiterate. He is literate. Is there any difference in meaning? No meaning. Only form is changed. Okay. Let us see another. Another negative sentence. Nothing is impossible. Nothing is. Nothing is impossible. Sentence is negative. What will be the affirmative? Yes. The affirmative will be everything is possible. Everything is possible. Nothing is impossible means everything is possible, isn't it? Everything is possible. Okay, so this is how we change negative into affirmative and vice versa. Now let us change some affirmative into negative. Okay, let me write a sentence like this. Affirmative. I did it with a good reason. I did it with a good reason. This is an affirmative sentence. What will be the negative? I did it with a good reason. It is not without reason, I did it. Okay, yes. So, negative will be, it is not without reason, I did it. I did it with a good reason. It is not without reason I did it, isn't it? Is there any difference meaning? Nothing. No. No difference at all. See this affirmative sentence. Okay, this is all I possess. This is all I possess. This is all I possess. This is an affirmative sentence. How can you convert it into negative? Yes. Negative. This is all I possess. I do not possess anything else. Okay, you're right. So, I do not possess anything yes. This is all I possess. I do not possess anything else. Is there any difference in meaning? No difference in meaning. only the form of the sentence is changed. This is how we do the transformation of negative and affirmative sentences. So, transformation of sentence means simply changing the form of a sentence without altering the sense of the sentence. Okay, whatever transformation it is, this is what is happening in transformation of sentences. Now we have done the first two kinds of transformation. So, now let us do some drilling and practice, then it will become very clear to you. Okay. I will write some 10 sentences. Miscellaneous type. All types of sentence will be there, whatever we have discussed. Miscellaneous types of sentence will be there. So, you will have to convert each kind of sentence into the other as has been directed. Understood? In the bracket, I will give some direction into what sentence you will have to convert. Into that, you convert. So, I will write some 10 sentences. Okay, see these sentences. There are some 10 sentences here. Some direction is given in the bracket. So, you will have to convert all these sentences into those sentences as has been shown in the bracket. I think you can do it. All these kinds of sentences we have already done. So, first sentence into assertive, second into interrogative, third into affirmative, and so on. So, I will give you some 5 to 6 minutes time to do this task. And afterwards, when I discuss the answers, you just compare your answers with my answers. Okay, right. So, now as per the direction, you start doing this task. And you pause your video now and start doing this exercise. And when I discuss answers, you compare your answers with my answers. Okay, right. Your time starts now. Okay, successfully completed the operation, right? Let us see the answers. You just compare your answers with my answers. How kind of you to have helped him like that? How kind of you to have helped him like that? Of course, the sentence is an exclamatory sentence. You have to convert into assertive. How did you convert it? See your answers. How kind of you to have helped him like that? What does it mean? It was very kind of you to have helped him like that. So, what will be the answer? It was very kind of you to have helped him like that. It was very kind of you, not it is, because to have helped, this is in the past, not true. So, you have to use it was very kind of you to have helped him like that. Instead of to have helped, if you had to help, what will be the sentence? How kind of you to help him like that. Then you can say, it is very kind of you to help him like that. But since this is in the past, you have to use force. Okay, right? You got an answer? Okay. Then, stop talking. Of course, the sentence is imperative sentence, command. You have to convert it into interrogative. Stop talking. Are you converted? Will you stop talking? Will you stop talking? Question mark. Okay, you got it? Right. Then, I can't help going there. I can't help going there. What do you mean by I can't help going there? I must go there. Isn't it? That is the meaning. So, I can't help going there. Of course, the sentence is negative and you have to convert into affirmative. So, what sentence will it? I must go there. I can't help going there means I cannot but go there. Isn't it? I must go there. So, the affirmative will be I must go there. You got it? So, see your answers. Who is not afraid of COVID-19 now? It is a very relevant question. Who is not afraid of COVID-19 now? What does it mean? Everyone is afraid of COVID-19 now. You have to convert into assertive, isn't it? This is question. Who is who is not afraid of COVID-19 now. What does it mean? Everybody is afraid of COVID-19 now. So that will be the answer. I hope you got these answers. These are very simple things. I wish I were young again. I wish I were young again. Of course it is assertive. You have to convert into exclamatory. I wish I were young again. What will be the exclamatory of this? Oh, that I were young again. Oh, that I were young again. Exclamation mark. Okay, right. That will be the answer of this. Is there any sense in doing that? Is there any sense in doing that? Of course, interrogative. You have to convert into assertive. Is there any sense in doing that means there is no sense in doing that. So what will be the answer? There is no sense in doing that. Don't say there is no any sense in doing that. It is a common mistake. So don't use any with no. There is no sense in doing that. So that will be the assertive of this. I hope you got it. Then everybody wants to be rich. Everybody wants to be rich. Obviously the sentence is assertive. You have to convert an interrogative. What will be the interrogative? Everybody wants to be rich. Who doesn't want it to be rich? What will be the answer? Who doesn't want it to be the rich? Question mark. Who doesn't want it to be rich means everybody wants to be rich, isn't it? Okay, then it is indeed a disgrace. It is indeed a disgrace to the family. It is indeed a disgrace to the family. So sentence is of course an assertive sentence, and you have to change it into exclamatory. Then what will you get? What will you get? What a disgrace. What a disgrace to the family. That will be exclamatory of this assertive sentence. Then a crow can never change. My pen is not writing well. A crow can never change its color. A crow can never change its color. Never. It is a negative word. So this is a negative sentence. You have to convert it into interrogative sentence. So how can you change this assertive into interrogative? A crow can never change its color. Can a crow ever change its color? Can a crow ever change its color? That will be the interrogative. So can a crow ever change its color means a crow can never change its color. Okay, meaning is same. Gopal never misses grammar classes. Gopal never misses grammar classes. Of course, sentence is an assertive sentence. You have to convert it into affirmative sentence. No, this sentence, Gopal never misses, it is a negative sentence. So assertive sentence is also negative. You have to convert into affirmative, isn't it? So Gopal never misses grammar classes. What will be the affirmative? Gopal always attends grammar classes. Gopal never misses grammar classes. Will become Gopal always attends grammar classes. Okay, right? So these are very simple things. I hope you understood how to convert the first two kinds of sentences. The transformation of the first two type we have completed. In the second session we will do the next two, and in the last we will do simple compound vowels. According to the difficulty level I have arranged it. These are comparatively simple. These are not so simple, and this is a bit difficult. It is a higher order grammar. So that is why exclusively one session I reserved for that. So we will do those transformations in the coming classes. And I think there is no need of any recapitulation at all. These are very simple things, and we have discussed everything. So I hope you enjoyed this session. So if you enjoyed this session, please don't forget to click the like icon. And if you wish to subscribe the channel, that also you can do. and till we meet with our next transformation, transform for active and passive sentence and positive competent superlative degree sentences. Okay, take care. We will meet again soon.
Okay, thank you.